Hey fellow hoarders, it's Angry Turtle, and yes, in this video I want to talk about how to squeeze more stuff into your stash box, as well as how to make a mule, what is a mule, and how to use it to the maximum of its efficiency. And we are starting from the stash box. And no, in this video I will not tell you how to increase the carry weight on your character, because it's a very big topic. Maybe I will do a separate video about it, as I don't have one yet, although other YouTubers cover it, then if you really need to know, you can search on YouTube. Now, stash box. As you know, you can fit there 800 pounds of weight. It will increase with next year update, but at this moment it's 800 pounds, and what you can do to improve that? The biggest issue will be junk, and unfortunately, in the junk section, as you can see, I have only stuff that's not scrapped into the pieces, and that's heavy, but I need it. Therefore, I have it in here. I don't have any other scrap because I do have followed first, and that's unfortunately the best option to squeeze your junk is a paid option. Although what you should know, you can save money because you can just buy followed first for 1 month, fill up your scrap box, and then use this junk even after your followed first will expire. But that's one thing, and that requires money. Then let's start talking about stuff that do not require money and can help you improve your storage space. What usually takes space in storage? It's legendary armor and legendary weapons, at least in my case. I do not keep food there or stuff like that, I keep it on myself, but in stash box I have weapons and armor. And now, not everyone realizes. Like for example, if you don't want to use one armor piece for a longer period of time. Like I have this life-saving jetpack service chest piece. I don't think I will be using it again anytime soon, as I basically don't need it at this moment. The weight is 10.85 pounds, almost 11 pounds. And now look what happened if I change the mods. First, the base mod, back to standard, that do not cost anything. Then the jetpack, swap it to ultralight because that's the lightest one. And look at that now. The weight is 1.4. I compress it by like almost 10 times. That's insane. You know how much more armor you can stash if you change all of them to standard and ultralight? You will have all the armor that you can use later and you are not using on the daily basis. It's insane saving in weight. Now the weapons. When you need to stash the weapon that you will not be using for a longer period of time, the same rule applies. Let's take a look on this fixer. At this moment, the weight is 11.25 pounds and it's modded. Now, let's see how much we can save by changing those mods. And in case of rifles, usually the standard mod is the lightest one. And look at this fixer now. 5.75, half of the weight, what means you can store twice as many weapons in your stash box. That's another simple trick you can use to squeeze in more stuff to use later. Of course, don't do this with the weapon that you frequently use, and you will spend a lot of materials to keep modifying back and forth. The other thing that can take a lot of weight you probably don't need is what I have in here, a lot of random ammo. If I will toss it away, I will save a lot of weight, but at this moment I still have room in my stash box, therefore I keep those, but using your ammo exchange machine is a great thing to reduce the weight of ammo, especially the heavy one. As you know, you can sort it. On the bottom of the screen there is sort and assign button, for my case it's Q. I put it and sort based on weight, and I can see what's my heaviest ammo, and by just getting rid of the heaviest ammo, I can save a lot of weight. And there is much more stuff that you can manage in your stash box, but you can do it. Just sort by weight and take a look what you have in your stash box, and if you can, reduce the weight of heavy items like weapons or armor. If you can, you will save a lot of space. Now about muling things. The best and easiest thing is having your mule on your friend account, on your wife account. That is super easy and allows you basically unlimited storage. Let's take a look on mule on Mitzi's account. And as you can see here, there is like over 100 weapons. I can scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll. It's insane amount of weapon. And how is this possible? The answer is in armor that Mitzi is wearing. The mule is wearing. Regardless what this armor is, there is one important attribute. The third star says weapon weight reduced by 20%. By putting all 5 pieces with exactly this effect, weapon weight reduced, and it doesn't matter if it's cloaking, nocturnal, or whatever else, just weapon weight reduced. With all 5 pieces like that, all weapons are 90% lighter, which means I can store 10 times more weapons than I would be able to store otherwise. That's insane improvement for your mule. And if your mule is on different account, that's basically all you need to do, and you are set with almost unlimited storage. Now, what if you don't have a separate account to use? That is a little bit more tricky, because you will need to use a container transfer of your items or friend to transfer the items to your mule. In that case, you basically do a mule, that's a new character, do it on your account, try to set up it for carry weight, possibly level up to level 50 to have more carry reduction perks unlocked, but it's not necessary, depend how much stuff you want to store. And then you use container. And you can use any container that says weight 0 out of 0. This means you can stash as many items in here as you want, and this way transfer it to your other character. But you need to know there is a risk involved, as you can lose those items if anything will happen to the server, or if you store it in a busy place and someone will just take it. But if you know about those limitations, it's a still great way to store items that you know are not very good at this moment, but maybe will be good in the future. If you lose them, it's not a big deal. If you successfully transfer them, it's great. As you know, in the past, like two-shot explosive was the best effect. Then it was nerfed and everyone was running bloodied weapons. And then bloodied was nerfed. And now the most sick after effects are like anti-armor and vampire. Then market is changing and a lot of people want to store some effects that are not top-notch at this moment, but possibly can change in the future. That being said, let me transfer some junk legendaries using this method and show you how this works. I will use the container at the purveyor, but this cabinet is a less busy place and hopefully no one will take it. Although for you, I recommend to find some place on the map where it's really low traffic if you want to do this transfer more safely. Let's toss in here like this Hunter's Fatman and maybe Junkie's Shepherd's Crook. Okay, 2 items. There is no limit, of course, you can transfer as many as you want, but if you have a lot of items, don't do it all at once. If you lose it, it's better if you lose a couple of them than everything. And now, how to go back to the same server? You need to open your friend list, and you need to have someone on your friend list that will be on the server and will stay on the server for at least another minute, as you need to rejoin the server. That's important. I have Mitzi, then it will be easy to rejoin the server. If you don't know anyone, try to find at least one in-game friend or ask for help in our Discord. It's not so hard to join on one person that will say, okay, yeah, I will be playing on this server for another 30 minutes or so. And then you know that it is a way to go. Now, after this being done, just go back to the main menu. Change your character to whatever else character you have. Go to your social tab. On your social tab, find the person that you know is still on the server you left and join. And now let's go and let's see if my items are still in there. Let's go check the container I left items in. Fingers crossed, let's see. Yes, Hunter's Fatman and Junkie's Shepherd's Crook, exactly what I left. And I can pick it up. If this will be my mule, he will have those items now. Safely stored. And that will be it. That's basically all you need to know to squeeze more stuff into your stash box. And if that's not enough, create a new character to store even more stuff for later. If you are a hoarder at heart like me, you will need both. If you can limit yourself a little bit, you probably can go with just your stash box after compressing items a little bit. And now, as always, thank you a lot for watching and see you guys in the next one.